Morning students, I welcome you for this online class, the Sheba group of schools. So now we are going to the third unit. Already we have completed the first and the second unit. So each unit will be consisting of a prose, a poem and a supplement. You know that. So now we are going to the third unit, the prose lesson. So it talks about In Celebration of Being Alive by Dr. Christian Barnett. He is a doctor. So he writes his experience in this lesson. So celebration is always a great pomp and glory for each and every family. And we celebrate certain things. We celebrate our festivals. So with pomp and we celebrate certain things. We celebrate our school functions and other things. So celebration is there. But of being alive, that is very important. So we are alive. That is the great gift of God. That's the grace of God that we are all alive today. So we have to celebrate each and every day that God has given us life for us to live today. So this lesson, being a doctor, he has written this lesson. And we are going to see about the author. The author of the lesson is very important, I already told you. So about the author, see in page number 69, you can see the author with the photo of a doctor. It's the greatest open heart surgery doctor. Christian Nathling Bernard was born in a rural South Africa in 1922 to a poor parents of their fourth child. So he was the fourth son of that family. Was born in a rural, in a village in South Africa. He evidenced great interest in the academics and was determined to pursue medicine. So, although he was born in a poor family, what happened? He wanted to become a doctor. His aim was to attain. After his loss of his brother to a cardiac ailment. So, his brother died of the heart attack. Cardiac ailment. He won many scholarships and pursued his higher studies, specialized in cardiac. So what happened? He made up his mind to study regarding heart problems and heart diseases and the surgery or operating of the heart. So as a cardiac surgeon, Bernard focused on conventional and complicated cardiac condition for which there was no cure. So if there is any problem in the heart, it is not curable. So what happened? They have to transplant. He was the first person to transplant the heart, taking away the heart and placing another heart. So after experiment with the heart transplantation on animals, first he tried with animals, he performed the world first human to human heart transplantation, taking a human heart and placing it in a human. So we call it as a dead if a person is in the stage of death, that is, we take the heart of them and replace it in another person. In 1967, he gained a worldwide recognition. So that was the first operation where a person is being transplanted with the heart from another person. So the whole world was looking at that and adapted. So still we adopt the same position of taking a heart of a person by surgery. Now you would have seen many person living with a transplanted heart. So Bernard has penned 14 books. He has written 14 books, 235 scientific articles. So scientific articles he has written, which has been published in several reputed, in all advanced, well-known journals, newspapers. Some of his books are One Life and 50 Ways to a Healthy Heart. So heart is very, very important. So what happened? You have all the organs in our body is very important. That's why we ask them not to have any bad habits, which will spoil our health and our body. So he has written, the best medicine and the faith. Faith is very important. So So most probably they talk about that, the faith. A pioneer in cardiac surgery, he obtained a doctorate in medicine from the University of Cape Town. This was followed by 11 honorary. So he got a medicine from the doctorate of medicine, MD, in University of Cape Town. Then people, they came forward for his successful open heart surgeries. So 11 honorary doctorates were bestowed. Bestowed means given to him by all over the world, all the universities. They came forward and they honored him. He has also received 36 international awards. In his later years, he established the Christian Barnard Foundation. So he started a foundation for helping people, poor people. He started a foundation. You would have known about many foundations. All our cine actors also, they start some foundation to help the poor people. So here also what happened? He started a foundation, Christian Barnard Foundation, to serve and prompt the cause of underprivileged children. So he started this to help the underprivileged, those who are not able to afford for an open heart surgery. So what happens? He opened it throughout the world and he died at the age of 78 in the year 2001. So now we have known about this, the doctor of the first doctor of the open heart surgery. So now we are going into the lesson from page number 67. We all know that Dr. Christian Barnard was the first doctor to perform a heart transplant surgery. So he is the first person to replace a heart by a surgery. Here we have an extract of his speech. So he has given his own speech wherein he narrates an experience which has changed his perspective of life altogether. It's the incident happened in his life. So which changed his own life into another person. Transformation, that is very important. Let's find out what led to such a dramatic transformation. Manam maaradhun solluvom. Yeah, ore mari people irundite irpaanga. Yeah, kova padranga pathina kovathile irundirupaanga. Erichil padravanga. Yeah, so what happened? A stage will come for them. The people, those who are the bad habits also have seen. They will be going to the deathbed. Then they will make up their mind to leave. But sometimes it will be very late for them. Said here is transformed. So it is given by point over point. So first point. More and more as I near the end of my career as a heart surgeon. So I am going to get retired in my heart surgeon. So my thoughts have turned to the consideration of why people should suffer. It's a great question asked by all the people. Yeah, na kashtapadano. Why should I suffer? There are so many people there, but everything comes to me. Enakeda ella nadakkudhu appdin solrangalaya. So the same way, suffering seems to cruelly prevalent in the world today. Ellarkum irukudhu kashtamndrado illa ella vedana avamanam varumai idella vandu everybody has got. Do you know that of 125 million children are born this year, out of that 12 million are unlikely to reach 1 year. Oru vayasukku vara mudiyala evlo nearly 12 million. And 6 million will die at the age of 5. No, 6 million people, children vandu some diseases they were not able to cope up. Yeah, so what happened? They die. And the rest, many will be end of there. Some will be mentally retarded children, or some with the physically crippled. Yeah, physically handicapped are panga. So he gives the report about the children of the world. My gloomy thoughts probably stem from an accident I had a few years ago. I met with an accident. 1 minute I was crossing the street with my wife after having a lovely meal together. So after finishing our meal in a restaurant, what happened? We were crossing the road. So while we are crossing, what happened? The next minute a car hit me. First the car came and hit me and knocked me into my wife. So I fell on my wife and she was also, I pushed him and she also was thrown into another lane. and struck by a car. So another car was coming on the opposite side. So what happened? My wife got hurt. The car coming in the opposite side. So this is the incident. During the next few days in the hospital, I experienced not only agony, the pain. Because although he is being a doctor, he had made many operations, but still he would not have been realizing or feeling the pain of a person. But now what happened after the accident, he was able to see the pain of a person and a fear, but also anger. See, we were simply walking on a road. We didn't do any harm. But a person, they hit me and I hit my wife, and both of us got into an accident. I could not understand why this happened. Yes, and certain times we also ask the same question. I don't understand why this is coming, why this disease for us, why this type of poverty, why this type of unemployment in our family, why we are lacking in these things. So the same way he is also being a well-known doctor. So he thinks, why my wife and I had to suffer? Why should we suffer? We didn't do any harm. I had 11 broken ribs. So in my ribs I got 11 broken one and perforated lung. So I got some problem in my lungs also. And my wife had a badly fractured shoulder. So my wife got the fracture in the shoulder. This happened to us. Over and over I asked myself, okay, I had work to do. So I am a doctor now. I am so busy. So there are so many patients for me to take care. So I have to go. But the patients are waiting for me. My wife had a young baby. So we have got a small baby in my house. So she has to take care. But both of us are now in the hospital taking treatment. My father, if I go and ask my father about this reason, what he will tell? My father said, had he still been alive, but now he is not here, but if I go and tell him, he will give me an advice. What is that? My son, it's God's will. The will of God is very, very important. So he talks about my father. If my father is alive, if I go and send this, tell my incident to him, what he will tell? He will not complain anything about the people, those who hurt me. He will say that it's God's will. It has to happen. That is the way God tests you. To change you, what happened? God tests, put some problem in us for us to change. Suffering. Sometimes it may be suffering. Embalm you. Makes you a better person. To change you or put you in a better person to show you that you are a better person in this world. So this type of incident happened. So see what type of his father has got thought that without the will of God, nothing will happen. God's plan is there for each and everyone, those who are living in this world. He has given us life. He is the person who created us. He is the person who takes care of us. He is the person who feeds us. So he is the person who protects us. So it's all the will of God that you should be alive. The last day till you are in this world, it is the will of God that his father's advice is like that. But as a doctor, I see nothing noble in the patient. But as a doctor, pain is compulsory for an operation. If a person is sick, thrusting into a said, so what happened after the thing? They put it in the bed, in the hospital. Say, sweat comes out, mind clouded in agony, with pain on our mind. All the types of pain. Mental pain is there, physical pain is there. All the strain we have to bear. Nor can I see any nobility in a crying, a lovely child in a ward at night. The whole night some children will be crying due to the pain and agony of their diseases. But I have heard this. In those days, they didn't have sophisticated heart. So those days, they didn't have a very good heart surgery. I always found the suffering of children, particularly heartbreaking, especially because of their total trust. So what happened, the parents, when they bring their child to the hospital, they totally believe on the doctors and the nurse, those who treat them. So here he talks about, because he being a doctor, So if you have can't, they accept their fate. So sometimes what happen, for doing all the treatment and other thing, taking care of the child may die. So what happened, they simply put a thing that it is her fate or the child's fate that she has to die. So they live like that. They go through maintaining on surgery and afterwards they don't come. So after that what happened, they don't complain. So what happened, their life is only till there. One morning, so which changed, this is the thing which he experienced. One morning several years ago, I witnessed what I call as a grand prix of Cape Town's Red Cross Children Hospitals. So I was there in the Red Cross Children Hospital. There was a grand prix. Grand prix, you know that it's a car race. Yeah, namala formula anduvanga, formula car race. So grand prix. So it happened there. Well, how is it means? It opened my eyes to the fact that I was missing something in all my thing about suffering. So although I was suffering with my pain and all my fractures and other thing, this missed me. Something basic that was full of a solace for me. What happened there, that was that morning? So what happened is telling the incident what happened there in the hospital. So that morning, the nurse has left a breakfast trolley. See, you can see the picture. The breakfast trolley is there, full of breakfast and other things for the patient. And where soon this trolley was condemned, so there was nobody to take care. So what happened, two boys, those who were in the hospital, one became a mechanic, another became a driver. So the driver is driving, another is a person who is there. So that incident, the mechanic provided with galloping, so moving like this, the trolley, while the driver seated and he was pushing the trolley. The choice of roles is he became the mechanic and he was totally blind. So the boy who was there was blind and the other person was having, not the boy who was sitting in the front. Yeah, he's a blind boy, and the back who is pushing, see, he was using only one hand. The other hand has been amputated, it's been removed. They put a quiet. Let me tell you about these two mechanics. For all the 7 years old, one night, when his mother, so he talks about the mechanic boy. So what happened, the incident what happened is, he had a drunkard mother and father fighting. They throw a lantern, or velakathikku podranga. It fell on this boy and he was burnt and he lost his eyes. Another person who is not having the hand, how it happened is, the trolley driver I knew better a few years earlier I gave a surgery also. I had successfully closed a hole in his heart. He had returned to the hospital because of his malignant tumor. He has got a tumor, that is cutting on the bone. A few days later, the race, his shoulder and his arm. So before that only, the shoulder and the arm of the boy was amputated. Amputated means removing. There was a little hope for his recovery. After the grand prix, he proudly informed me that the trolley's wheel. So we were doing the correct thing, and I was driving correctly, and the mechanic was also correct. Only one reason is the wheel in the trolley was not put oiled. So we have won. Suddenly I realized that these two children had given up me. Now these two children has given me hope. That day, one is a blind fellow, another fellow is a boy, is a fellow without an hand and amputated. Because of the business of living in joy, some of us think that what we earn is a very good living. The life which we live is a great thing, because the business of living is joy, then pleasure, amusement, recreation. So when money comes, what happened? The change of the person. The business of living in celebrating the life, they forget about the life. The only thing is they lead a very pleasure life. I had been looking for suffering. So what happened? I was only thinking of my suffering, which is a wrong end. You don't become better person because of your, only think of your suffering itself. You will be not thinking of another person's suffering. So, but you have to become a better person because you have to experience another person's suffering. We can't appreciate light if you won't know darkness. So, we will not appreciate the light when you are, so when you are in the darkness, you don't know what to do. Suddenly, a small light will make the whole room with the light. Nor can we appreciate warmth. So, when you are living in a cold country, a small warmness makes us feel happy. These children showed me that it is not what we are lost that important. So not the body organs or not the things which has been missing, but whatever we have with us, we have to show that importance. So what is left? So this blind fellow was able to, his arms and his legs were so strong, so he was able to move. Another boy, although he was amputated, what happened? He was able to push with one hand. So he taught me a lesson that hope and faith. Don't always think of your suffering. There are people more than our suffering, those who are living in this world. So this lesson talks about this. You are alive. That is very, very important. Think of that. Your life, once it is gone, you cannot regain it. Only once you are going to live in this world. So that life should be a worthy life. Not only to your family, not only to yourself, your family, for the society, for all the person, whatever good you can do, try to do good. And it will one day it will help you. So my dear children, so keep this in mind. So that is what he talks. Although being an open heart surgery doctor, he talks that it changed my life. These two small boys, they have been lost, they have lost things. But still they didn't think about that and they were able to use the things what they had. So now onwards what happened? I changed my mind. Now I'm clear that only the thing is, and I'm going to celebrate for being alive. So now the organs and other things cannot affect us. Being alive is a great thing in our life. So always praise God for keeping you alive. There are so many types of accident and other things which happen all around us. But God is so protective. He takes care of us. He always keeps our eyes on us and He always looks for us and keeping us safe. So may God keep this in our mind and keep our life safe and live a happy life. May God bless you. Thank you for being with me in this lesson. Thank you, students.